Well, it's running a little bit right now. Not going to do much. It's about 2 mils. Pretty much all this does is stop the dust from flying around and keep the flies out of your eyes. So she is dry as chips. And, well, there is nothing out there for the livestock to eat. There's just all the butts of what we call buffalo grass, which has kind of been a saviour to a lot of southwestern Queensland. Bit of a problem for the mallee down there, but horses for courses. It's been a massive saviour, especially for lighter countries here. Lighter sands, buffalo grass is prolific and has a huge root system, and it's just absolutely been fantastic for really raising production on our grazing lands. Of course, grazing lands are marginal. What that means is it doesn't rain that often. You cannot grow crops there. So to make these lands productive, agricultural systems are not worth getting involved with, because it's just you're really chucking money down the drain. So of course, grazing systems are what they're all about. And the buffalo grass has really raised the potential of a lot of this country by putting a great cover on it, and of course, getting access to all that moisture that's there. You can see right now, things don't look too good. However, 30 odd years ago, when this definitely was agricultural country, and we grew a lot of crops here, where we grow things like forage sorghum, and we put these pits down, just because that's what you do in rural Australia. It doesn't matter if the drought's not gonna come for 10 years or 30 years, you prepare the moment that a drought breaks for the next drought. And so 30 years ago, probably a little bit longer, 32 years ago, all of this silage was put down. Now, how does silage work? Just like wine. Absence of air means it doesn't rot. So just like you can put wine away down in the cellar, down here you have these huge big pits, you put plastic over the top, all of your silage, and that really is just chopped up, in this case, sorghum. So you can see in amongst it, you can see all the seeds in there and all the fine chopped up bits of, well, forage. Now it grows about the height of my head, and then you chop it all up in this. And it smells like a cross between molasses and wine. And it stays underground and like this, 30 to 32 years. So when there's a drought, you open it up, you access it, you use it with a loader. So what's a loader? It's the same thing that you'll see doing all those housing sites everywhere. Huge big bucket with several cubic feet. Feed truck. And that food truck over there takes it around and feeds it out to all the animals. That's pretty much so what's happening on this farm to all of their thousands of heads of cattle and the sheep that are still around. Any other land animal that is existing in this area is also being that size. So kangaroos, emus, wallabies, even your birds, because there is no tucker out there other than what we've put down underground. That silage, that is one of the incredible ways that you can really get through these droughts. In fact, on this farm, it's the only way they're getting through the drought.